My dear students, now we will see about hydrophily. What is hydrophily? Hydrophily is the pollination, is a type of pollination taking place by water. Water pollination in general is called hydrophily. All the hydrophilous plants produce hydrophilous flowers. What are the hydrophilous plants? Some of the hydrophilous plants are given. Number one, hydrilla. Number two, vallisneria. These two are the examples given in the book. And they are the hydrophilous plant produce hydrophilous flowers. In the hydrophilous flowers, fluorophores are either reduced or totally absent. What are the fluorophores? Calyx, corolla, andrexium, gynoecium. They are considered as the fluorophores. The fluorophores may be reduced or totally absent. In the hydrophilous plant, in most of the cases, pollen grains contain mucilage covering just around the pollen grain, just around each pollen grain. There is a mucilage covering to protect from wetting. So that is the adaptations seen in hydrophilous flowers of the hydrophilous plant. In some cases, for example, acornia and water lily, pollination is not taking place by water. Even though hydrophily and water lily are considered as the water plant, living in the water, growing in the water, and they are considered as aquatic plants, even though in these two cases, water pollination is not taking place. Instead of water pollination, these two plants are pollinated by wind, anemophily, or insect, entomophily. Either one of the type will be taking place in these acornia and water lily. So that is the general things. Come to the types. There are two types of hydrophily: epihydrophily and hypohydrophily. What is epihydrophily? When water pollination takes place just above the water, on the water surface, when pollination takes place on the water surface, that is called epihydrophily. For example, in the case of vallisneria and elodia, epihydrophily type of pollination is taking place. Second type is hypohydrophily. Zostera marina and ceratophyllum, two examples given. In these two cases, hypohydrophily type of pollination takes place. What is hypohydrophily? When water pollination takes place inside the water, below the water surface, at the bottom of the water or at the middle of the water, when water pollination takes place inside the water, that is called hypohydrophily. So these are all the two types of hydrophily. Now we'll pass on to the pollination in Vallisneria spiralis. In Vallisneria spiralis, epihydrophily type of pollination takes place. That means on the surface of the water, pollination takes place. In Vallisneria, there are two plants, male plant and female plant. Because it is a dioecious plant. What is a dioecious plant? When a plant produces male flowers and female flowers separately in separate plant, in male plant, male flowers, and female flowers, and such a condition is called dioecious condition. Not only that, Vallisneria is a submerged, rooted hydrophyte. It is a submerged plant. It is growing only inside the water, and the roots are fixed the plant in the mud. It's a rooted hydrophyte. In the mud of the pond, in the mud of the lake, they are growing and produce roots which affix the plant firmly in the mud. in the female plant, female Vallisneria, female flowers are produced in single. Solitary female flowers are produced with long coiled pedicel. Pedicel means stalk of the flower, so that the female flower can reach the surface of the water and freely floating on the water surface. As far as male plant is concerned, in male plant, male flowers are produced in group, in inflorescence, because the male flowers are very small. Several male flowers are grouped together and form inflorescence. What is inflorescence? When a bunch of flowers are produced, when a group of flowers are produced in a special branches, that bunch of flowers or group of flowers of the same species, that is called inflorescence. Here, as far as Vallisneria is concerned, male plant produce inflorescence, male inflorescence. But female plant will not produce inflorescence. Female flowers are produced in single. Solitary female flowers are produced. As far as male flowers are concerned, the pedicel is very short. After maturation, the male inflorescence produces male flowers separately. So, several male flowers detached from the male inflorescence and floating in the water reaches the surface of the water. The female flower, just around the female flower, a cup-shaped depression is formed. Just around each female flower, a cup-shaped depression is formed. When the male flowers, which are floating on the water surface, come in contact with that depression, cup-shaped depression, the female flower, that will be trapped by the female flowers, and the pollen grains of the male flower reaches the stigma and pollination is affected. After pollination is over, the stalk of the female flower coils and brings back to the pollinated flower at the bottom of the plant, where fertilization takes place, fruit formation takes place. That is the pollination and fertilization and fruit formation of Vallisneria spiralis.